honorary mayor of South Alexandria. So I had to recognize you. She runs an area. So you have to be obedient. And you have to give honor, huh, Randy? You have to bow your heads. Good to see Ms. Ellen, no problem. But when you see young folks in church, it makes a difference. And they could be doing so many other things, but they are in church. And I want to thank all the men, the women from United who are here about education. Education is a big equalizer. Don't let folks fool you. If you look at the opportunities that Ms. Helen had in her days and what these young folks have, it's night and day. We have to take advantage of the education opportunities. Young folks, take school serious. There's value in education. Some of you all will be graduating from high school. Go to college, but you have to take the Bible with you. Be serious. A lot of folks attended college, all they had was like $3 or $4. Now you've got hundreds of dollars. There's no reason why you can't be successful, young folks. There's so much opportunities. You have more technology in your phone than we ever could have. You've got computers, you've got laptops, you've got iPhones. We never imagined those things years ago. Years ago, we had to go to the library and check out a book that was always missing. You got all technology on the hip right here. Let's use it. Let's stay in school and let's stay focused. We had one part of the LEAP test a few weeks ago. We have another part coming up. Kids, take school serious, listen, follow directions, pay attention. Yes. If you want to be successful, you have to stay in school. Yes. When you get these scholarships from these churches, you thank the Lord for and you take it serious. When your friends say, hey, I want to go party, no, that's Reverend Hamilton money. I got to come back and bring a degree. That's Reverend Gilmore's money. I got to come back with a degree. That's a Mount Trials, but I got to come back with a degree. When you go off to college, you have to come back with that paper. You have to. Don't go there for a semester or two and then come back home. That's not what it's all about. You have to stay the course. If you're unable to go to college, then you go to community college. But get some type of skill, some type of trade. Young folks, you can't live off $10 an hour. It's not going to make it. We've got jobs out here. We've got a new plant in Pineville. They're paying a lot of money. We want y'all to be prepared for those jobs. You can make a difference. But you can't make it off $8, $9 an hour. Amen. Those days are far gone. Amen. But please, when we bring these jobs to the community, please take advantage of them. Stay in school. Stay focused. Watch your attitude. Watch those drugs. Please. To give you a vocal point, the city of Alexandria hires about 900 employees. City of Monroe has about 1,200 employees. The city of Houston has about 30,000 employees throughout the city. Our biggest concern is that you have to pass that test. Stay away from drugs. Stay away from drugs. Here. But once again, gentlemen, I want to thank y'all for inviting me. I look forward to this beautiful service. I'm going to step out earlier. But understand, young folks, when they give you something, you tell them thank you, and you work hard to bring back that paper. Thank you.